Editor-at-Large Ahmed Al-Barai joins us now live in the studio to speak more about what's happening between the Houthis and the Saudi-led coalition forces that are there now. First of all, is it in either the Houthis or the Saudi-led forces' interests to actually close this port, even for a short period of time, or prolong this battle there, considering that it is effectively the only properly working port in the country?
Of course, it's not in the sake or the interest of the Yemenis. Mainly, it supplies, it's the lifeline for millions of people. It's the main lifeline to all of them. And it handles roughly like 80% of the essential goods.
But militarily, what does it mean to the Houthis and the Saudi-led coalition if it closes? Strategically, does it work for either side to shut down this port? Go ahead.
For the Houthis, it is a stronghold. It's the main lifeline for their supplies coming from the Iran or any other places. It is very essential for them because if they lose this stronghold, they will be boxed in Sana'a, the capital city of Yemen. And in that case, they will be pulled to the negotiating table with the conditions of the Saudi-led coalition, and that's something they don't want to do. And I don't think that they're going to back down this or a relinquish their control on this important port for the coming battle. So it depends on the Houthis whether they're going to dig in or they're going to back down. And in case they dig in, I think it's going to have like a bloody street battle comparable to Aleppo. And this will cast like dark ramifications on the people who are already suffering in this impoverished country.
So it is worth fighting for. How long can this go on then?
Again, it depends on the Houthis, the Saudis, and especially the Emiratis, because, Andrea, we have to put things into context. It didn't start with the Al-Hudaydah. It started with Aden last year, then Socotra. And the interesting thing, you don't have any Houthis there. So it's the Emiratis who do have a kind of a hidden agenda to control all the ports on the Red Sea because it's very essential for the shipping economy, for their industry, for their own ports. And that's why you would have this kind of, they're not allowing the internationally recognized government, Abd Rabbo Mansour Hadi, the president of Yemen, to be in Aden. And that's a big question mark. Though we do have so many statements come from the officials speaking about more than 2,000 people who have been trained in Eritrea and they're moving to the Hudaydah to start the offensive, the ground offensive, which means it's going to be a large scale offensive. The problem is you do not have a clear strategy of the Saudis, even if they defeated the Houthis on the stronghold, which is most probably not going to happen very easily. It's going to take longer time.
And civilians will pay the highest price.
Of course.
Okay, Ahmed, thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you.
Now,